anybody on anybody's side. But I do feel like just at least matchup wise, I'm gonna say it. I think Roy is gonna struggle. Matchup wise, I think Roy struggles.
I just want to hear Roy's our boy chant from the crowd.
From the game crowd or the live crowd?
From both.
I don't want to hear it from the live crowd. That would make me upset. I mean, but the game crowd, I'd
if it's deserved. If it's deserved, we'll see.
I already don't like when they clap at different songs.
Okay. And Falcon is already off stage.
Actually, you know what? I take it back. I don't mind clapping at Dreamland. What I did hate is when we all sang the Pokemon theme song at a tournament. I didn't like that one.
Oh, I wasn't there for that, and I'm happy. I'm happy I wasn't there for that.
Yeah. Okay, so here we go. Zane Troy versus S2J's Falcon. I'm not even kidding you. Yesterday, oh, you saw it. Yesterday at the Korean restaurant we were at?
Yeah.
I went up to the table that had like Mango, Null, Johnny, Lauren, and then I asked, or no, they told me, it's like, or Null was complaining. It's like, they're out of rice. They don't have any more rice. There's no rice left. And then I look at Johnny, he's got a plate full of rice. I'm like, did they only give you rice? He's like, yeah. Just for Johnny.
Some bias. Oh my God.
Hey. Took range works out.
What a forward smash.
Okay, stomp punish by Johnny, but that down tilt actually stops the follow-up.
Yeah, so we've seen it before. You see a lot of down tilts from Roy. A lot of use from Dancing Blade. It's a good way for Roy to clean up stocks, getting that third hit forward to Dancing Blade.
And Roy actually a solid weight to be comboed by Falcon.
Oh, no jump still. Johnny makes it back to the ledge. Okay. Ooh, love the weight.
Yeah, that was a really good weight to get the grab. See the punish.
Oh, okay. Oh, no jump.
Yeah.
This might be a stock.
Now, Roy does have that actually beneficial up B recovery that lets him go pretty horizontal. So normally that position would have been curtains for a Marth, but Roy actually had a chance to up B into the stage still.
Yeah, Roy's recovery really isn't terrible.
It's not terrible. Right? It's not the worst.
Uh-oh. Falcon's off stage.
Oh. Hit him at Marth range, I guess.
So, yeah, some of those hits are just, they're just kind of laughable.
Yeah.
All four hits of the Dancing Blade.
Yeah, but you know, like, Zane is totally okay with nickel and diming Johnny.
I mean, you have to be if you're going to be playing Roy. It's going to be a lot of your existence. Yeah, what do we call a four hits of the Dancing Blade? Is that like a waltz? What is that?
A waltz? I have no idea. I don't want to know.
Yeah, up throw knee.
Gets the up throw knee, but that's after a ton of damage that Zane ended up pulling off. And like, you know, even though Roy isn't getting anything like punish-wise, right? The fact that Zane is choosing to still play at Marth range to get the damage and rack it up until Johnny is at a point where a forward smash would kill. That's a lot of discipline and a lot of really strong neutral and spacing.
It's a small little miss. I mean, you gotta give it to Zane. He has played this stock immaculately. He took 0%. What control? The spacing is unreal. Uh-oh.
The roll, bit of a flub. No. What the hell?
Keeping him in the corner.
How?
How do you get out? Falcon took 80% just in that left side.
Yeah, defensively, Zane is just a monster.
Oh, no. Oh, no knee. Doesn't go for the knee. I think he has a jump. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, and that recovery mix up makes it tough.
Oh, the get up attack.
Johnny, no jump. Oh, that's I don't think Zane misses these.
Oh, that was a free one. Oh, there we go.
Wow.
That's another one. So,
are
you aware? I'm sure you are. I played the game long enough. So, the third hit of Roy's Dancing Blade, if you opt to do the up one, if it hits, it's a meteor.
Oh.
So, it sends him down.
Yeah, I did not know that.
Yeah, so, like, you know,
a long time.
There are some little setups that you could do on the ledge there if you get.
You used to be a Roy main. You told me that, right?
That's how I started the
game.
Yeah, before I knew L canceling or anything like that, I was like, this guy has a sword. And he has, you know, there's fire attributes.
Yes, that makes sense that you know that. I was never a Roy main, so I had no idea.
It was very alluring. Okay, don't test me. Taking the first game. see what S2J can do here to adjust. The wave dash sounds, it's too much fun. Some characters just have those sounds that just, like, really stick out on this wave dash.
Wow.
And there you go. You call that an adjustment.
Yeah, stronger start for Johnny here. I just feel like the last game, Johnny had a lot of difficulty getting anything started. It's just Zane's defense was way too on point.
Zane trying to find a way in. I'm having a lot of trouble doing so. Oh, there's the waltz. Oh, goes for it again.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that
here.
Last hit goes pretty high. It reaches up pretty high.
Yeah, I guess it's not too bad.
Excuse me?
They're Roy's zoning each other.
Oh, okay. You don't see that?
Hey, that works. Dash attack works.
This gives them the shoulder thrust?
Yeah.
Oh. All right, we're missing L cancels. Commanding lead for S2J here. And that's going to be another stock.
Yeah, I mean, there's no horizontal distance that's going to get you back from there. That four stock lead. Big statement from Johnny at this point.
Yeah, this is looking like a quick clap.
Yeah. And I'm wondering if the stage has anything to do with it, because
wow, okay.
Maybe the lack of space is making it easier for Johnny to get in, whereas on Stadium, he struggled with Zane's defense. And
perhaps
Zane's ability to just keep dashing away and pick his spots a bit better. Smaller stages might be more beneficial to Johnny in this matchup.
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, it just looks like Johnny's playing much cleaner this game, and Zane just can't get anything started.
I imagine there's always got to be some sort of adjustment period when you're playing against a Roy, because it's such an unfamiliar matchup for most players.
Sure. Oh, there it is!
Oh,
there it is! That's exactly what I was talking about.
If you didn't tell me
that
before, I would have thought it was a glitch.
All right, someone needs to move me a little bit further away from Zane. He must have heard it.
He heard it.
He heard it.
All right, so is it not meteor cancelable?
I think it
didn't
is.
Look
I don't
like
think
it
it's,
was. I didn't see the little spark. You know what I mean?
I'm 99% sure it's not a spike, but it is a thing. And now we've seen it happen. Down tilt knee is also a thing, and that cleans it up. 1-1. What a shot of Johnny just yawning right there.
He had a lot of rice yesterday. Makes it tired.
Hits a knee, ties up the set. Gets a good yawn in. All right, where are we going? Of course.
Strong game, and I wonder if Johnny had made the adjustment now. Or if that was just like a weird game, which does happen sometimes. You know?
Yeah, it does.
This game will absolutely give us that info. And despite what I was saying about the stage being smaller and being more of an advantage for Johnny, Zane still ends up taking it down to Yoshi's story.
Yeah,
so there must be something Zane is seeing.
Well, I mean, I think there's a couple things. Roy's F smash is how he's cleaning up most of these stocks. And it's going to kill here much sooner. Furthermore, like Falcon, you know, you want to stifle their movement for the most part. Smaller stages are typically a better pick against Falcon. Oh, beautiful air dodge, because that would have been a KO. Standard, tight battle.
I like how Zane was trying to call out a jump by Johnny by just going for a raw forward smash on the top platform.
Beautiful. Okay. The weight.
Yeah.
I love the weight. Nice power shield. I'm surprised that was a strong
hit. Is that
hit.
A confirmed?
It's a DI mix-up from my understanding, but I'm surprised that it wasn't the weaker hit. It looked like that was like Marth range, like Tipper. All right, they're both just kind of dancing around each other right now. Nice slide off from S2J. Puts him in a good position here. Yep.
Okay. Close game. It's possible that Zane also wanted the option of the early KOs. here on this stage. Oh. So maybe the neutral suffers a little bit, but the stocks go by quicker.
Yeah, Zane trying to put that dancing blade to work. Like I was saying before the set started, it's a huge tool for Roy.
Oh, that dash dance behind with the grab.
Oh, no jump.
Hey, Zane's edge guarding immaculate, except misses there. Keeps it going, though. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, it's a little tough.
That drift was tricky.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh. Ah, the reverse lightning.
What?
Okay.
Oh.
Yep. Stock.
Zane hasn't gone for too many dares, but the few that he has, he's missed the L cancel. You have to wonder if playing Marth all the time, you know, messes with that timing
a bit. Oh, no pummels for before the up throw. The up throw might have killed it with just a bit more percent.
I think, wow, that was really close to killing. Oh, the butt grab from Falcon. He has a good one.
I think Johnny very aware that a grab is what Zane wants right now. Gonna try to play around it. Maybe even possibly bait it like that to get that side B into down air into a KO. Yeah. Johnny.
Man,
I like that awareness. You see it? Like, knowing that the best option for a KO there is for Zane to get the grab, and then Johnny just starts playing around it, baiting it.
Yeah, if you can pick up on those habits or what your opponent's looking for, it's huge. It's like the fox that just, like, always throwing out an up smash whenever you're in kill percent.
Exactly. Yeah, like, it's always a thing you want to look out for and try to take advantage of.
Okay, so we have FD. This is... I don't know. This is going to still be very hard for Roy.
It's going to be tough, but I think Roy, at least I believe that Zane is looking for a lot of sharking and a lot of easy damage by juggling Falcon on this stage.
Yeah, well, at the end of the day, I don't think the platforms are really doing Roy any favors. So,
no. It doesn't feel like Roy has the tools to take full advantage of the platforms. Rest Falcon, I think, has better tools to take advantage of the platforms.
Uh-oh. Down throw? Yep.
Okay.
Can we get started here? Maybe neutral B?
Yeah, Zane's so good at edge guarding with Roy.
Nice. That'll do it. All right. Three stocks apiece. Yeah, FD's just Zane's comfort zone, as it is for most... sword characters in Melee. Predominantly Marth, of course.
And Roy's spot dodge seems a lot faster than Marth's, I believe. So Zane using Roy's spot dodge pretty liberally.
Yes, he is. And SDJ, once again, making a lot of use out of air dodging.
Calls out the long horizontal recovery from Roy. Gets the edge guard.
Off stage. Nice weight. Oh no, that's rough. All right, dancing blade. Yep, one more. Beautiful. Gonna have to get one more edge guard here though. That's
good
tricky.
Drift from Johnny. Yeah.
Calls out the jump.
Okay.
Johnny's thrown out maybe four Raptor boosts total this set, and he's hit most of them.
Yeah. This match is staying very close, despite the dominance of Johnny in the last two games. I think Zane might have found what his strengths are in the matchup.
Nice.
It's space and the ability to juggle.
Oh, that covered almost everything. Might have covered everything. Ooh. From the spacing there. Oh,
wow. Okay. I get it. I get why that could happen.
See ya.
The DI's
I'll see you later.
A bit tricky. Ooh, get smash DI out of the nair to stay. Yeah, to actually get a counter grab.
Air jumpstone, air dodge. Oh, Zane's all over him. Oh, that was risky.
Oh,
yeah, I think
mess up.
Uh-oh. If SDJ can get a grab here, It should just be an easy up throw knee, but.
Yeah, but it's going to be tough for him to make it back. Ooh, finds a way.
Has to get back onto the stage first. Yeah. Look at this, neutral.
Full distance neutral from both. Of course, Falcon is going to have a good time just covering that space.
Oh, what a legend. Oh. Who is this guy?
Okay. Game five situation. Zane two stocks Johnny right back.
That's right. Don't test me. Being tested. Game five.
You know what's funny? I feel like Zane has more clutch with Roy than he does with Martha. which I think falls into my theory that he's used to just being outright better than players most of the time.
Yeah.
That when he gets put in a spot where he's at a disadvantage, it's kind of hard for him to figure out how to win while you're losing. You know what I mean?
Which is something
that Hungrybox is very good at. But with Roy, you kind of have to be in that spot all the time. So I'm going to say that Zane could grind his clutch factor by sticking to Roy at more events.
Yeah, I mean, well, forces you to play better, yeah. Literally. Okay, so.
Terrible advice, but I hope he still does it.
Correct me if I'm wrong, did we see Dreamland at all? We didn't, right?
No.
I'm surprised.
Why not?
I'm surprised that S2J, and I'm sure chat is also surprised, like, why did we see Dreamland? I mean, that's, to me, that just seems like a. It's like a GG, right? Like,
the only reason I'd say, or the only argument I'd have against Dreamland is that Johnny seems to have been doing well with the lack of space.
Oh, no.
And despite the fact that Roy's going to have some trouble killing on Dreamland, I think Johnny likes the lack of defensive options for Zane on this stage.
Interesting.
Versus a bigger stage like Dreamland.
Yeah,
it feels like Johnny wants to smother the Roy.
Oh, this is not looking good for this fire-wielding swordsman. Wow.
Ooh, okay.
Okay, on the board. Big deficit, though. S2J, massively. Yeah, I think that if you took a poll and asked most Falcon players, like, hey, where would you go in this situation? Game five, you have any Dreamland? Yeah. They're all, I feel like almost all of them are going to say Dreamland.
Yeah.
Especially when you're like looking at Fountain. I mean, a lot of Falcons despise this stage. Okay, so Zane really has to make something work here. Down throw.
And it's going to, because Roy doesn't have those really quick KOs that Mark might be able to get with a precise down air, it's going to be a lot of work for Zane. It's going to be a lot of neutral wins.
Uh-oh.
It's going to be a grind. Meanwhile, it's like while you're staring down a Falcon that can kill you in one hit, it's going to be tough.
Okay, well, Zane making a bit of a comeback. It was pretty difficult looking from the start of this match. Oh, gets the grab, though. Oh, bad DI. Uh-oh.
Okay.
Oh, you know the crowd wants to see a last stock situation here. I want to see last stock.
It'd be hype. I just don't know if Zane's going to be able to get there with the way that Johnny's playing.
Yeah, that platform height is doing
dodges it.
Johnny a lot of favors this entire match.
Yeah, and it's like this comeback's going to be so hard because I just can't think of a Roy move that turns things around. You know what I mean? It's going to have to be, like, a process.
No. Oh,
Zane's doing it, though.
That might have been it, though. That might have been it.
The edge guarding is where it happens. Zane needs that. I cannot believe that miss.
That's unfortunate.
Oh, double jump from Zane, but still manages to make it back down. Oh, that DI on the nair.
What's
crucial.
Oh, that's it. Man, Zane had two, three opportunities to clean it up with an F smash in the corner, and just missed, but well played by both players.
Johnny smiling.
Yeah, he's like, thank God I didn't get blown up on stream by this. let's go. Good stuff. All right. Yeah.
Yeah.
So good set. That was a good set.
Game five.
I wanted to see it. I wanted to see game five.